Hey, what's up? It's week for Xiaomi Fight, and today we're looking at Viomi's all-new vacuum robot, the Viomi SE. A lightweight and much cheaper vacuum robot. But is it any good? Let's find out. Let's go! In the box, you'll find the vacuum cleaner itself, two side brushes, a floor mop, a separation floor mop, and two single-use floor mops, a dustbin and water tank combination, and a docking station with the power plug and some instructions. So the Viomi SE is 35 centimeters in diameter and 9.4 centimeters in height, weighing in at around 4.6 kilograms. Comes with a 3200 milliamp hour battery that gives it a 60 up to 130 minutes of operation time. It's got a Nidec motor with 15,000 rotations per minute, giving it its 2200 PA suction power that produces up to 75 dB of noise on its highest suction setting. Just like pretty much all of the other vacuum robots that we've seen here, it can ride over 2 centimeter thresholds. Comes with a combination dust box and water tank. With a dust box of 300 milliliters and a 200 milliliter water tank that allows you to use the same box for vacuum cleaning and mopping. On top of the SE, you'll find its laser sensors for navigation. It's got the LDS collision and LDS ranging sensors, water tech detection sensors, and things like a gyroscope, which will also detect if it's being lifted off the floor. And it can also detect stairs so that it won't fall off. You can remove the brush on the bottom of the vacuum cleaner to clean or replace that if needed. And you can easily attach the side brush by simply clicking that in place. So the Viomi SE comes in white with rose gold, which is a very new color scheme when comparing it to the V3. And we'll look at the similarities between those two in a little bit. But first, let's give this one a try. So the vacuum strength on the Viomi SE is pretty much enough for regular everyday use. It's capable of picking up all of this rubbish that I've laid down here on the floor, and it did a very good job with that. I've set it to run the program twice, which you can set from the app, and it actually cleaned and picked up everything that I threw on the floor to try it out with. It does not have carpet detection though, but it worked out well, as you can see right here in this example. And with this test, I've actually set it to its highest suction setting, which is actually something I do all the time. Mopping is working just as fine as with the Viomi V3. It's got controllable water settings, so you can control the amount of water that is being used for mopping from within the app. Just like on the other flagship robot vacuums, you can set the SE to the regular S pattern mopping curve, which will have the SE go in this simple zigzag pattern, or you can set it to this Y curve mopping pattern, which will have a much more thorough path to mop. It will take a little bit longer to mop, will obviously use a little bit more battery as well, but it's also a lot more efficient. Now, I've set it up using Xiaomi's Mi Home app. That's just like installing any other device, and once it's installed and connected to your Wi-Fi, you can access it through the devices page. From here, it will automatically create a map after its first run. So I first had to clean the entire house so it would map out my apartment, after which I can set up zoned cleanups if I just wanted to clean the kitchen, for example. You can actually rename these rooms, and you can make separations. You can also give areas where you don't want it to vacuum, so that's quite flexible. From the app, you can start and stop the cleaning, set the vacuum strength. You can set the amount of water that is being used for mopping, and I can set up scheduled cleanups or smart home automation rules. From the settings menu, I can set things like the mopping pattern, which I've actually set to using the Y pattern, but you can change that to the S pattern if that's what you want. So overall, I find the Viomi SE to perform well. It's got all the functions that you'd expect. But then why is it so much cheaper, and how does it compare to the Viomi V3 or the V2? So here's the specs. You can see that some money is being saved on the SE by giving it a smaller battery, which gives it an hour of operation, which I guess is still fine. And it's got a slightly different motor that does not have the suction strength of the V3, but it does have a little bit of a higher suction strength than the V2. The SE only comes with the combination water tank and dust box, whereas the V3, which will have three different boxes included. Although, if you want, I believe they will actually separately sell the single dustbin or the single water tank if you really need those. So, if you really want them for the SE, you could additionally buy them. The SE also uses the same internal chips and the same LDS sensors as found on the V3. You can actually see that it's also a little bit less noisy than the V3 as well. So overall, I gotta say that the Viomi SE is very, very similar in terms of functionality when compared to the V3. Sure, its motor is not as strong, its battery is a little bit smaller, and it does not come with those three dust boxes and water tanks, but nonetheless, it's good. It performed well. Like, it didn't feel noticeably less strong than the V3, and it's got the same mopping features as well. It's got all the same software functions in the app. It can save multiple maps when you use it on multiple floors in your home, for example. So I actually think that the SE is a very good choice when looking for a more affordable vacuum robot that is still very capable, but does cost quite a bit less. The Viomi SE came out with a temporary deal for around $299 US, or around 250 euros, and it will go for around $340 US, or around 275 euros, once this temporary deal is over, which I feel is still a very fair price for this vacuum. I've also put down some links in the description below this video in case you want to go and check it out. So just in case if you were wondering if this one works well...
This is ridiculous.
After the first run and just these few tests that I've done for the video, you can see how much stuff it had picked up.
What?
I was actually quite surprised. So that is about it for the Viomi SE. I think it's a well-performing vacuum robot. It's got a lot of functions that the flagship V3 has as well, for a much better price and, well, a different color, if that's what you're into. So what do you guys think of the Viomi SE? Is this something you want to go and pick up? Or perhaps not? Let me know in the comments section below this video what your thoughts are, and let me know if this is something that you feel is worth picking up. Don't forget to leave a little like below this video to show me that you like it, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit that bell icon to get notified about my new videos, as I'm doing a lot of videos about Xiaomi and Xiaomi ecosystem companies like Viomi right here on the Xiaomi Fi channel. As always, thank you guys for watching, and I hope to see y'all soon. Peace.